Ooh! So we're at a lovely property today, and it's got damp issues. I've been called in to investigate and tell them why and tell them how to fix it. So look. Dung, 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 dung. It's hollowed, huh? It's plasterboard. Why do you think that is? And looky, looky, what can we see? Ooh! We got like a bit of rust and beading. We've got some little cauliflowers. So that's good signs of moisture evaporating. Ooh, ooh! And what have we got here? More peeling paint. Yeah, he flicks off. Come round here, what can we see? More peeling paint. So, visuals, lots of peeling paint. Some of it's quite high as well. And we got a bathroom. Ooh! Guess what's behind the door? Quick, take cover! Look at those bullet holes. Chemical DPC above the skirting board. Absolute waste of time. So we know there's a history of damp issues because the cowboys have been. And guess what we're going to do now? Have a little looky, turn all the taps on. Nice bit of hot water and a bit of cold water, whatever you want. And you can see along here, we got poor seals around the bath, a little bit of a cracked tile. Now, lots of these things you've got to get down low and actually see. Let's take the bath panel off and voila, what can we see? So I've used the thermal imaging camera to visually demonstrate the actual hot water leak on the trap. Yep, it's a leak on the trap. So think about it logically. Every time you use the bath or the shower, this is all going to be leaking, sat on the concrete. And look, look how wet it is. Oh, yeah, she's wet, she's wet. Get the skirting board off, little bit of weevil, absolutely saturated on the back, long-term dampnesses. So damp meters, absolutely brilliant, brilliant tool. So the Survey Master is my go-to tool on this type of investigation. So I want to use pin mode, I want to use scan mode and deep wall probes. The reason is we need to know what's going on and think about how to repair it. We also need to know if there's any salts in the plaster. Is this damp just because of the leak, or is there underlying issues? We know there possibly could be another problem there, because it's been damp-proof before. There might be some salts. It's an older building. So we map out the moisture using the pins, and also map out using scan mode. So this goes into roughly just up to about 20 mil. What can we see here? Oh, we got a high reading. What do you reckon that could be? Eh? Oh, and I like to use a deep wall probe. So when we're taking the samples deep into the mortar beds, I like to use a deep wall probe, so take this right to the top of the wall as well. And map out the high readings in the floor around the adjacent areas. Simples! Take some plaster samples and see if it's actually wet. See if there's any salts there. Again, so we can give the client the best advice. Also, we've got a lot of black ash mortar around here. It does give you a few funny readings on the damp meter. Oh, and what can we see? A blockage in the drain. Circumferential cracking. Typical. We see this all the time, multiple contributing defects. Now, this is where the clever bit comes. We've got to negotiate this branch and boom, we're straight through. That was first time lucky. It can be a pain. But what do you think we're going to find on here? What do you think? Typical, 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 typical. Voila. Look, another open joint. Now, this is what I always find. I always find these problems. That's why you got to get back to the toilet. Now, what am I going to find there now? Look at that massive hole. Flush the toilet. That water's clean. There's no poop all the way in there, so you haven't got to panic. And when the toilet flushes all the water out, what can we see? All the water ponding in the open joint. So now for some science. BRE Digest 245. So what we've got here is a moisture profile. So the blue line is the capillary moisture, and it shows the sample at the base of the wall, 10% of its weight was actually water, which is absolutely ridiculous, but not surprising considering what's been going on there. But the red line is the hygroscopic value. That is where you get your nitrates and chlorides, and you can see at 1250 millimeters from the floor, you've got that big peak on there. And that is where we got the big high readings on the damp meter. So the damp meters have been very sensitive around the salts. So the damp meters helped us define where the salt is. Brilliant. So on this survey, I'm only acting as the damp consultant. I'm not going to repair the building. But armed with all of this information, I can be 100% confident. I can give my client the correct diagnosis and also tell them how to get this job repaired once and for all. But thanks for watching, and we will see you soon in the next one.